name's Henry Lukas. I'm the education director at the Spellman Museum of Stamps and Postal History at Regis College in Weston. And this is our December show. Our shows involve connecting postage stamps that have commemorated famous historic events and famous birthdays of people each month of the year. And we're hoping that after seeing this, you will think about making a visit to the museum. We also can send you copies of many of these stamps that we mentioned in the show by just emailing us. But let's start right from the beginning of the month, December 1st. Interestingly, there are two Independence Days celebrated on December 1st. Way back in 1640, Portugal got its independence from Spain. And in 1918, the island country of Iceland became independent from Denmark, still stayed within the Union, and then finally in 1944, Iceland got complete independence. And then in 1990, the very famous Channel, which is about 31 miles long, that connects England with France, on December 1st, 1990, they made their final breakthrough of the last rock layer. And 4 years later, the Channel opened, and that's been celebrated on stamps. December 2nd, an important date in French history, Napoleon was crowned Emperor of France by Pope Pius VII. That was in 1804, and you'll see a stamp that shows a famous painting that was done by Jacques-Louis David of the coronation. It's a huge painting, 33 feet by 20 feet, and if you've been to France and the Louvre, you can see that painting. The coronation, by the way, took place at Notre Dame Cathedral. And then a year later, Napoleon, making his advances to conquer Europe, he defeated the Russians and the Austrian troops at Austerlitz. He wasn't as lucky invading Russia. The same day, December 2nd, one of our presidents, our fifth president, James Monroe, issued the Monroe Doctrine, which said that the Western Hemisphere was off limits to any incursion by any European countries, and that doctrine has stayed in effect. It was a big deal back in 1961 with the Cuban Missile Crisis. Notice the stamp, by the way, of James Madison, of Monroe, rather, is a 5-cent stamp indicating that he was our fifth president. In 1942, on December 2nd, Enrico Fermi carried out the world's first successful nuclear chain reaction at the University of Chicago, which led to the creation of the atomic bomb. And in 1859, the famous artist Georges Seurat was born. And here's a stamp from a country in Africa, Rwanda, honoring his painting. We move to December 3rd, and if you get out a dollar bill and take a look at that picture of George Washington, that was the one that was painted by the famous artist Gilbert Charles Stuart. He was born in Rhode Island. You can visit his home place down there. And he did over 100 portraits of George Washington, which he sold to raise money, and did over 1,000 portraits of all our famous patriots during that time. Interestingly, he died a poor man. And if you can honor his grave, all you do is go over to the Boston Common, and in the Pauper's Cemetery there on Boylston Street, you'll see the grave of Charles Stuart. 1857 is the birthday of a very famous author born in the Ukraine, but moved to Poland and then to England, Joseph Conrad, who's famous for his novels, Lord Jim and Heart of Darkness, which are still read by many high school students. December 5th, sad day for the Mozarts. Mozart died a pauper in 1791 in Austria, very young age of only 35. But even at that young age, he had composed over 600 musical compositions. And as you can see, there are a number of stamps from all different countries have honored Mozart. 1933, big celebration in the United States when Prohibition was repealed by the 18th Amendment. The 17th Amendment, or the 16th Amendment rather, I'm sorry, started the Prohibition in 1929. Not too successful. It was the height of the 20s. And you can see the other stamp that kind of celebrates the jazz age and what was going on during Prohibition. 1955. Down in Montgomery, Alabama, the bus boycott begins with Rosa Parks refusing to give up her seat on the bus. December 6th, the 13th Amendment to the Constitution is adopted, and that abolished slavery in the entire United States. It's a very famous statue called the Freedmen's Memorial. It's located in Lincoln Park in Washington, D.C., and it's on the stamp that you see. That stamp was issued to celebrate the anniversary of the amendment. And then a man named everybody knows, Thomas Edison, in 1877 on December 6th, he demonstrated for the first time his phonograph. And what did he use to play on the phonograph? Nothing more than that nursery rhyme, Mary Had a Little Lamb, which incidentally was written by a woman, Mrs. Hale, from Boston. We have 1921. If you have some Irish blood in you, you know that that was when the Irish Free State was established. It was called the Irish Free State until 1937, when it changed its name to Ireland or Erie, and you can see the stamp. Interestingly, that stamp, even though it's Ireland is still a divided island, you know, on their stamp they put the whole island of both the free and the one that's still controlled by the British. 1896, we have a famous birthday of a great writer of music and lyrics. Ira Gershwin was born in New York. He wrote such songs as I've Got Rhythm, Someone to Watch Over Me, The Man I Love, and of course well known for Porgy and Bess, and of course his brother George, who's also recognized on a stamp, one of our great two brothers in our history of our music in this country. December 7th, everybody knows, was the day that will live in infamy, as President Roosevelt said as he addressed Congress, and that horrible day has been commemorated on several stamps, both the series that came out on the anniversary of World War II, and also the Arizona Memorial is honored on a stamp, you can see there. 1787, December 7th, we have Delaware becoming the first state to adopt the Constitution. You can see the seal of Delaware on that stamp. We have the birthday of a president in 1782, Martin Van Buren. You can see him here on an 8-cent stamp, which means that he was our 8th president. And he was the first president actually born a citizen of the United States, since he was born after the Revolution. One of his famous quotes is, "It's easier to do a job right than to explain why you didn't." And he also got the nickname Old Kinderkahook, which is a place in New York along the Hudson River. And some people say that's where our expression OK comes from, Old Kinderhook. From the when he was president. December 8th, a sad day for the Beatles and all those who love the Beatles' music. John Lennon was assassinated by Mark David Chapman outside the Dakota Apartments in New York City. And John Lennon has been honored on a number of stamps, including this one from Germany. A birthday on December 8th is a man named Eli Whitney, born right here in Westboro, Massachusetts. And some people say he's responsible for the Civil War, since his invention of the cotton gin made the production of cotton in the South much more productive and valuable, and therefore kept the institution of slavery alive. Notice, by the way, a little stamp history. He's on a 1-cent stamp, which is a green stamp. And interestingly, for many, many years, all 1-cent stamps all around the world were green, and 2-cent stamps turned out to be red. Eli Whitney's also very well known for the interchangeable parts and the assembly line. December 10th, we have some famous people associated with that day. One of them is a man named Alfred Nobel. We all recognize the Nobel name for the Nobel Peace Prize. He died on December 10th as in 1896. And of course, he's well known for his award and of course for the invention of dynamite, which was one of the reasons he created the Peace Award, because he was upset after inventing the dynamite that it was used not just for construction and making tunnels and blasting away, but also in war. In fact, he got the word dynamite from the Greek word, which means power. He was almost going to call it safety powder, because the first few experiments he did were not too successful, but he chose to go with that. And if you ever have a chance to visit Stockholm, there's a wonderful museum there for the Nobel Peace Prize winners. And they have an interesting custom. They have a cafeteria there, and every time a Nobel Prize winner comes to the museum, they sign their name on the underneath of the chairs in the cafeteria. So, 1787 is the birthday of Thomas Gallaudet. He set up the American School for the Deaf and worked in all types of education, and he's honored on a stamp. And a man who hasn't been honored yet, but probably should be, a man named Melville Dewey, and you recognize not Thomas Dewey, who ran for president, but Melville Dewey, who started the Dewey Decimal System and organized all our libraries. And an interesting thing I found out about him, he has a middle name that has a stamp connection, Louis Kossuth, which we have a stamp issued by the United States in our Freedom Fighters series. He was a leader in 1848 of the Hungarian Revolution. And I'm not quite sure why Dewey picked that middle name, but it's an interesting one. And by the way, he set up his Dewey Decimal System right here in Massachusetts at Amherst College. December 11th, big day in English history. Edward VIII abdicated his throne because he wanted to marry Wallis Simpson, and then the new king, King George, became over. And we have a famous mayor of New York City, a man named Fiorello LaGuardia, who was born in 1882, known for really modernizing New York City. But he's also famous for, during a newspaper strike in New York City, when the children weren't able to get their Sunday comics, he actually got on the radio and read many of the comics so the children didn't miss their Sunday comics. First Chief Justice of the Supreme Court was also born on December 11th in 1745. His name was John Jay. December 13th, if you go to the other side of the world, a man named Abel Tasman discovered New Zealand, and also there's an island off the coast of Australia called Tasmania, which is named after him. And in 1835, a Bostonian man named Phillips Brooks was born in Boston. He was the minister of the Trinity Church, which is honored on a postage stamp, and he's well known for many things, including writing the song, O Little Town of Bethlehem. December 15th, up in Canada in 1964, they adopted their new flag, and you can see the copies of it on the two flags, one issued in that year and another one issued 50 years later on the that. Interestingly, however, the stamp was printed on paper made in Wisconsin. In 1832, the very famous Alexander Eiffel was born in Dijon, France. And in 1889, his Eiffel Tower appeared in the exposition in Paris. They were almost ready to tear it down a few years later when they determined that because radio was becoming so popular, it became a tower for broadcast radio. Unfortunately, the Eiffel Tower was not torn down. So, and then December 16th, we have the Boston Tea Party, where 342 crates of tea were thrown off ships there in the Boston Harbor. In 1944, Glenn Miller, a famous band leader, disappeared over the English Channel. And in 1901, on December 16th, Margaret Mead was born in Philadelphia, very famous for all her anthropological studies. Got a lot more events in December to show you, but our time has run out, so we hope that you can visit us at the museum. And if you'd like a copy of our calendar, which features of these events, then we'd be happy to have you send us a letter. And since it is Christmas time, as we go off, we just want to wish you Merry Christmas and come over here and maybe you'd like to buy some stamps as a Christmas present. So thank you for joining us, and we'll see you next month.